So this talk is about the Spyglass Storage Engine, which is a federation storage engine and a charging storage engine for MariaDB, for MySQL as well. What is really new in the storage engine is that it has been set for MySQL 5.5, and now we are trying to make it work with the new optimizer of MariaDB 10 and MySQL 5.6. We have some features of the optimizer that has changed a lot. So things have to be adapted for the final solution. So usually it's a hot topic, sharding. Who is in the room using sharding already or has some sharding solution? Yeah. 10%. So who is using a framework inside the application and not inside the database? Or, yeah. Who is using NDB cluster? Okay, very few. So usually sharding is frightened because people are usually afraid of the database system, afraid of sharding, afraid of clustering, and MapReduce, what's that stuff? Lots of bad words. And of course, if you are afraid of privacy as well, then you can take it here. So sharding is breaking the database into pieces. We refer to partitioning when it's inside the database itself, and we refer to sharding when it's outside the database. So, for example, building two servers, two database servers, would be a type of sharding. It's the most common type of sharding, meaning that you have single database, then you put two of them, and you put separate schema inside them, and then you have some sort of sharding. But there are also some sharding that for columns or horizontally charts. Here, Spider is the way to chart the data horizontally using a storage engine partitioning API.
Yeah, it actually extends the partitions that you already get inside of MySQL 5.1.
Exactly. The storage engine is developed by a Japanese guy called Kento Fushiba with very limited English, but now it's improving a lot. It's a quite old storage engine because it started this project more than, I think, 5 years ago.
Yeah, the engine is quite mature. It's been around since 2008, 2009, and it's been in production in multiple places since then.
So the idea is to provide a sharding inside the database system, so it would be transparent sharding to users and transparent sharding to applications. In MariaDB 10, we try to have to offer the choice. The choice is the storage engine layer, so the things that are storing stuff internally on the server. So it's InnoDB, TokuDB for high compression, MirrorDB, high compression as well. PokuGraph, very specialized storage engine to do graph computation on edges and everything. And then we have some other collection of storage engine that link the tables outside of the Ansible server. And here you can find a Spider. We talked this morning about Collect storage engine, Federated X, Cassandra, Hashbase, Munga, and SciencesSearch, which are more like search-oriented, full-text search-oriented storage engines. And this is per table. You choose MariaDB or MySQL, you choose your storage engine per table. So that's nice, because then you can choose exactly what you want, what feature you want per table. And of course, the replication is also tunable per table. And we introduce in MariaDB 10 multi-source and parallel replication. And of course, all of this you can filter per table. So you can add some filters to say, oh, I want to replicate this and this.
Dynamic replication filters always.
Oh, yes. In MariaDB 10, it's dynamic. You can just set your filters, remove them as you want. OK, so this is basically the architecture of MySQL and MariaDB. You have the client, it's talking to something, which is called the parser. Yeah. It will produce a parse tree, and then we go to the optimizer. So usually you talk here with the SQL language, the optimizer will produce the query plan, and then it will be executed. But then you have different way of going to the storage engine API. It's by the handler, and also by handler socket. And in MySQL, for example, you can also have here men catch photo that can directly access to the storage engine. But what Spider is doing is able to, it's plugged here, is able to talk to the optimizer, go directly here or here, and go to the backends underneath. And one special trick is the problem here is the optimizer will call many times here the storage engine. And that's a big problem because what to do with the backend when you have multiple calls like this? So this is called in Spider a semi-transaction. It means that it will, even if you send a simple query to the MySQL server, you will open a transaction on the backend. To make the consistency of the transaction between the calls consistent. So it's transactional storage engine. That's important to say it. But then, what you can do is send directly your query directly to the backend. And this is a hack. And Spider use UDF to do that. Then you can take a query, put it into this UDF function, and you have two ways to run it. Or it's a UDF function that runs in parallel, concurrently, or it's a UDF function that runs serialized. And what Spider is doing is it's taking shortcuts sometimes. It's taking the query, it's detecting, for example, it's a sum query, or you know the famous com star from you know, the table, it's slow. What it will do, it will send it directly to the backend like this. So it will shortcut the optimizer, take it and send it. And this is transparent to the user. You don't have to set anything for that. So it's kind of map reduce. So when I say what is semi-transaction is implementing a lot of functions that the optimizer is calling when he's producing a plan. So when he's executing a query, many times he will call those functions, and Spider implements all of these functions. And we'll go back and refer back to the storage engine on the remote backend. So from the storage engine to the remote backend. And then it will be all inside encapsulated into a nice transaction. The threading model of Spider is very interesting. It's a connection pool, but the connection pool is activated by every session or every connection you do to the database. You run your query, and then it will grab a thread from the pool to talk to the backend. So Spider is able to maintain here. So you define the sharding, and then it's able to. Every time you run a query on the partition, for example, on the partition table, you will pick a thread and keep that thread in a cache to reuse it later. And you have some special threads as well, which are the threads that are taking the statistic and the show table status to get the statistic and the metadata of the dictionary of the remote backend. And those threads are independent. They can do the work like sending a show table status or show index to grab the cardinality of indexes in the remote backend. And we will keep that and maintain this own dictionary inside. Or everything is tunable in Spider. You can also do that at every query that you run on Spider, but it will be more costly, of course. But it consumes less memory, less space. So what is the typical use case of Spider? Is this one, a single federation engine. You have your Spider table and your backend, and you link to the same table. But Spider can do the federation engine also with HA. Means that the same table will be replicated on the two backend with XR transaction, like a NDB cluster. In the last Spider release, the XR protocol has been improved. It's an improved protocol, like on MDB cluster. It's fast and it's more fast. It uses less run trip. How to do it? First, you create a server in MySQL. So that's a classical MySQL or MariaDB command. Create server. You define the host, the database, the user, the password, the ports. There's some more. The protocol also you can define here. You could say it's MySQL, but it's mandatory. And then you create a table. You're not forced to do that. Fader is able, like Connect, we saw this morning, is able to auto-discover the scheme, the DDL. So you can just skip that part.
The auto-discovery is only available in Spider from MariaDB. If you use Spider from MySQL, it's not there. Yeah.
And then you say that the wrapper is MySQL and the server is the backend that you have defined here. Okay? Quite easy. So execution flow of Spider, here are the features. So you have Spider for MySQL, which is based on MySQL 5.5. You have a lot of features. And you have MariaDB 10, the current release, and the release candidate, which we are working right now with the Spider developers. And so it's a configuration per table. For example, what is cool is that you can say that this table will use the query cache or not use the query cache. It's a common problem. So you can abstract this and say, for example, that every time you will use this table, then you will activate the query cache on the backend. So it's a way to use the query cache more efficiently and that to be transparent for the developers. You can use SSL connection, of course, for the backend communication. You can also force an index on the remote backend, which is quite cool. Then lot of things. Load data also can be bulk, and inserts can also be bulk. So if you have a group of inserts in separate transactions, then you can say, okay, I want all those inserts to be bulk inside one bigger transaction. A lot of stuff. So
did foundation push is coming?
Yeah, it's done already, but it's coming. Not in the release candidate, but not in the current release, but in the release candidate, you will have engine condition pushdown. Concurrent partition scan, batch key access is done as well. Blockage join, that's normal, that's coming from MariaDB and MySQL as well. Okay, and so you can map reduce, max, min, sum, group by function. All the dynamics can also be pushed to the remote backend. Take care with that, it needs to be a function that are able to be pushed to the backend. It's not always the case. But you can force it. And then you can relax, here in the last feature, you can relax the backend consistency. Means by default, it's consistent. The Spider is doing things with transactions, but you can relax this to have something very fast. For example, this is called, we will see later. So this is a benchmark that we have produced. So you see that we are comparing MariaDB 10 native server. So we are sit-benching this. Then this saturates the TCP stack. We are using HAProxy to protect the TCP stack. We are using MySQL proxy at some point. It's green, MySQL proxy here. And two threads. But it's very small hardware, so don't take those two graphs, okay? Seriously. But because it's only four cores, very slow. But it's to show a little bit the. And Spider is here. So Spider as well, like he has a connection pool inside, has also protected the TCP stack. Without tuning the TCP stack, then we are able to produce more concurrency on the server. What you can do is point update and point select. You see that the performance is decreasing with one Spider table, but then you have two Spider table. You see that the read scalability is good. So you add three Spider table, then the read is good. And then you see that the two-pass commit protocol, it's not because you will have more nodes that you will get better write performance, because more you have nodes, the more the two-pass commit protocol will take time, okay? So what you can do with Spider is something very similar to MySQL cluster with notebooks, meaning that here you shard, so you have one table and you shard on three nodes, but you can also shard and replicate. So here, for example, we have a notebook, then another notebook, and another notebook, and one node can go down. The system will just remove that node that is down from the group communication. How to do it? Very easy. Like this. You create your servers, of course, and you put one server here, and the replicate here, and then another server for the other partition, and the replicate for the other partition. This is the monitoring feature of Spider, and we are saying here that the server that is monitoring is the server ID of the Spider server here. Here, this one, for example. But here we have three Spider. We could, of course, there's an election between the three, we will see later. So I create my monitor server here, for example. And here I have to define who in those servers are the monitors. So I did just define one, but usually you should define three servers to get a majority consensus on if this node is down. So if one of the nodes is down, then there will be an error on insert, for example. Then this will detect the error and talk to the other spider through what is defined in that table, spider link, mon server, my server. Okay? So this table is strange because it's Japanese and it says mon server, which is quite French. So this table defines who are the spider nodes that are participating into the majority election, knowing if a node is down or not. So what we see in the HA feature is that we are missing some stuff. For example, when the node that is down is removed from the cluster, it is not able to re-enter the cluster. To do that, it's in the roadmap. We will use multi-source replication from RDB10 to then catch up with the replica and re-enter the cluster. So it's in the roadmap, and we will do it. What the spider can do is talk also to backends that are not MariaDB or MySQL, like Oracle, but try to compile it with Oracle's client libraries. And also, spider can attach also local tables. So here is the process of node failure. If one of the spider or the partition that you call is failed, then you will contact the monitoring nodes. The monitoring nodes will do both type of, they can monitor each backend based on the policy, and this is the policy here. For example, do a simple MySQL ping to confirm that the backend is dead, but you can also do select one or select one from with a where clause. And this is how they will say, okay, I don't see that backend is dead. Then they will talk and have a majority decision here, and then we remove that node from the group communication. Then, of course, like Spider is not able to reintroduce the node in the cluster, you have to do it manually. And for this, the developers that are clever, they provide you one UDF function called Spider Copy Tables. Spider Copy Table is able to copy the tables and to catch the differences between the replica and the current spider. But first you have to put the node into a special status, because it will, like for Takona toolkit when it's doing online table schema change, it's exactly the same. It will catch everything that is happening in the source table to apply it to the destination table at that time. And by setting this link status to 2 here, you're telling him that everything that is happening will happen in the replica, okay? And then you copy. So here's the source, here's the destination. That you can farm into the Spider MySQL system table, with which ID is that. And then when it's done, you reintroduce the table in the cluster by putting 0 in the link status. By default, when the node is down, the link status would be 3, which means that the node is kaput and does not re-enter the cluster, participating in the cluster. That's so that's spider from SQL 5.5, and that this is the state of the current spider plugins in MariaDB. But now we are even more. We are here, okay. But this will be only released in the next MariaDB.
Yeah, it hasn't been merged yet.
It's not merged, but you can ask if you want preview. You can do it. So the main problem here, there were no pushdown condition and no background search, which means concurrent partition scan.
this will change rapidly, the 10.08, which company should be out in the next couple of weeks.
This is something I use for clients. It's using Spider to do sharding, so it's a pre-shard system with 24 shards, and we do insert into black hole tables. So we insert into black hole tables on a so we load balance on multiple nodes here, so we have multiple, and this is for taking statistics. And here we can do, we can produce like more than 1 million statistics per second. How we do, we insert into a black hole table on a spider table that short to black hole tables. Then we produce spinners, and with the group commit it's very fast. And then every real servers, they are already saved somewhere. With multi-source replication, we'll fetch some of the shards. So on a 3 or 4 nodes cluster, then we grab some shards, 1, 2, 3, 4, on that server, physical server, and blah, blah, and like this. And then here, we use triggers to rebuild some of the spider table with real DB tables underneath. So we do computation of statistics like this. What we found out is that the big node cache size in MariaDB and MySQL is a quite important value for high insert rates. This was another bottleneck here. Then we say that Spider can use direct duplicate inserts. In the original implementation of the statistics system, one was on a single MariaDB system. We did not, we were doing update on duplicate inserts. Like we put a black hole table, it's not possible, but Spider can give you the opportunity to rewrite the query into a single replay statement instead of unduplicate key. Because unduplicate key on the black hole, what's the problem? There is another case study where we have 200 billion records, and to do that, we have first a Spider table that is merged, that is partitioned by server. And then you have the real DB table, well, it's CompuDB in fact, because for the compression. Then we partition by time range, which means that you have a first level of abstraction that gives you to multiple servers, and then inside every node, we have partition by timeline. Like this, we are able to purge the data very easily by dropping the partitions. So here is, we get the right scalability here, and we get the dropping of the partition. These 200 billions are taking in 1 month time period. For batch key access is something you want to join. What is good with Spider, you can have your, well, the problem is partitioning. You partition the table, and then you have, for example, your invoice and your product table. The product table probably will not need to be partitioned because there are few products in there, many multi-millions, but it's enough for a single server. And then the invoice table will be the big baby or whatever. And then what you do, you need to copy this product table on all your shards if you want to join. But what you can do with Spider is use one federated on the product table and the partitioning and partition the invoice table. And then you can join and do things like this. And this is one of the big advantages of having the partitioning inside the storage and not in a proxy, for example. So here, what batch key access means is that you will not do the join like this, you will do the join like this. Fetch couple of rows, join, then fetch couple of rows, join. Means that for everything that is remotely on remote backend, it will be good because there's less network round trip, and of course the join will be faster. So with the partition engine, the performance is yet not so good. But you can bypass this by using direct UDF function. So here's the performance of a single 1,000 key access in, and you put 1,000 primary key, for example. This is on a regular MySQL on MariaDB, and this is on a partition engine with Spider, and this is using Spider direct SQL. here is a way to use that famous UDF function to do background direct SQL. You send the query here, you say the temporary table that will get the result, and then you give all the partition or the servers or hosts that have the partition. And this is grabbed from an internal table, spider system table, MySQL or spider table. By doing this, then this query will be sent and the result will be in the platform table. What you can do also, if you want to run it more in parallel, you can add some channel. So here in that connection screen, you will add CCH for channel and say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It means it will be running 5 threads in parallel. So, but this is normally it's transparent. So it's transparent for some counts, max, min. If you set spider casual reads superior R1 and spider background search superior R1, and this will be transparent and the query will be sent by a shortcut. Here is the way you debug, but you will get the slide, so this is not interesting. You can take general logs on the spider table, so you will catch every query to the remove backend and put that in the log. Okay? So the roadmap. Recovery with multi-source application. We are thinking of DDL synchronization and auto-sharding with a dictionary somewhere. And we try to in reality to improve the documentation, so now you have a good documentation in the KDE article of MariaDB. Ask our team any build. We have a lot of builds that are not yet merged, and then they are the people you can contact for having more information. They are users, and some are bigs. Big banks in Japan, a lot of users in Japan, CCM in France, and some editors that we are working with.
And that's the reason why I can also write the Oracle backend to visit Japan, Oracle is looking at it. Don't think we have time for Q&A. We'll be outside.
Sorry for the time.